In this video, we're going to take a look at how we manage our mail accounts on the iPhone with iOS 26. Basically, what we're able to do is add different mail accounts, such as Gmail accounts or AOL accounts, to our mail app. In this video, we're going to see how we can do that as well as manage those accounts. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we manage our mail accounts on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, let's first take a look at what I'm talking about. I'm going to open up the mail app. When I open up the mail app, what I'm able to do is view all of my mail accounts. In this case, I have two mail accounts. To do that, what we do is we tap on the arrow in the upper left-hand corner. And when I do, I can see my different mail accounts. So basically, I have two accounts here, my iCloud account and my Gmail account. So if I wanted to view all of my mail in iCloud, I tap on iCloud. I'm looking at all of my mail in iCloud. I want to view all of my mail in Gmail. I tap on Gmail. And now I'm looking at all of my Gmail, all of my mail from Gmail. To view all of them, so all of your mail accounts, what you do is you tap on all inboxes. And when I do that, it's including both those accounts. So that's basically what our mail accounts are. What we can do is we can add different accounts from AOL, Gmail, anything like that. So where do we go and set this up? Where do we go and manage these? Well, we do this in the Settings app. So I'm going to swipe up. And then what we need to do is we need to go over to our Settings app. I tap on it. And now what we need to do is we need to go to our Mail Settings. In order to do that, what you do is you swipe all the way up and you're going to see Apps down here at the bottom. I tap on Apps. And then these are all the settings for all of the apps that are installed on my iPhone. What I need to do is I need to go to Mail. So I swipe up until I find Mail. When I tap on Mail, it's going to show me all of the settings for my Mail account or for my Mail app. And in this case, what we're going to focus on here is Mail accounts. So let's go ahead and tap on it. And I can see my Mail accounts. In this case here, here are my two accounts, iCloud and Gmail. If I wanted to add another account, maybe I want to add another Gmail account or an AOL account, what I do is I tap on Add Account, and I can enter in the email address and then follow the instructions. Or if it is one from the main services such as Gmail or AOL, what you can do is you can tap on Choose from a List, and when I do that, we get the list and I can go and select what I want to add my account from. So if I have a Yahoo account, I can tap on Yahoo and follow the instructions. I have an AOL account I want to add. I tap on AOL and it'll add that account. I follow the instructions and it'll add that account. So that's how we can add an account. Now let's take a look at how we can manage these accounts, including how we can remove them. Now, first of all, what I want to say is when you have an account, it manages more than just mail. So when I go over here to Gmail, Gmail offers more services than just mail. What I can do is I can also manage my contacts, calendars, and notes within Gmail. So if I wanted to include my calendar from Gmail in the calendar app, I tap on that slider here, and it'll include that in my calendar app. But back to mail. Let's say I no longer want to use my Gmail account on my iPhone. To make it inactive, what we do is we tap on the slider here, and it'll make it inactive. So now when I go back over to mail, what you're going to see is just my inbox because I have one account. My Gmail account is no longer in here. So this is just my iCloud account. When I go and turn that back on and I go back over to mail, you're going to see that Gmail's back in there. So we can easily turn on and off accounts. And when we do that, it only affects this device, this iPhone. Now let's go back over to the settings. If I want to delete it, I can also delete that account. And then what it'll do is it'll delete it from the iPhone. It doesn't delete it altogether. You're still going to be able to go into gmail.com or AOL.com. All it does is just remove all of these services here from the iPhone. Just removes all of them. But it doesn't delete the actual account. You can still use that account on your other devices if you wanted to. It's just not going to be on your iPhone. If you wanted to change the label, you can do that as well. You tap on this and you can change the label. So if you have two Gmail accounts, you might want to call one Gmail 1 or Gmail 2, or name them for what they are used for. So that is how we manage our mail accounts on the iPhone. Basically, what we're able to do is add multiple email accounts from different services, such as AOL or Yahoo or Gmail. And when we do that, we can access those accounts within the Mail app. To do this, what we do is we go over to our Settings app, and then we go down to Apps at the very bottom, and then we go to Mail. And then you're going to see Mail Accounts. Tap on that, and you can go and manage your Mail accounts. You can add new accounts. You can make them inactive. You can remove them altogether. So that's how we manage our Mail accounts on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family. You can subscribe to my channel. In addition to that, I also have a couple of other options if you want to help support my efforts in creating these videos. I have danstutorials.com and dansonlinecourses.com. With danstutorials.com, not only do I have more videos, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. When you become a member of that site, what I'll do is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant. Now, this is a subscription site. If you don't like subscriptions, I also have dansonlinecourses.com. This is a course-based site, and it includes a course on the iPhone. This is a one-time purchase. When you purchase the course one time, you'll get all the videos for that course, in this case here for the iPhone. With either one of these options, just know that you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member or purchase a course, just know that you are helping support my efforts in creating these videos. Take a look at danstutorials.com or dansonlinecourses.com for more information, and thanks for watching.